Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Matt Meyer Road to the Show series here in MLB 14, the show. Our catcher is doing a great job here with the Frisco Rough Riders. As a matter of fact, he is in the middle of a 20-game hitting streak, just waiting for that call up to AAA, as things are going quite well at this level. Hopefully, it'll come sooner than later. So before we get into our game with San Antonio here, let's just take a quick look at the stats so far here. 136 at-bats, 6 homers, 22 RBI. He's hitting .382, looking good so far.
Matt Vasgersian back with the Minor League Pregame Show, counting you down to AA Texas League Baseball with tonight's version of the Bowman Prospect Spotlight. Matt Meyer is our subject, as he comes into this game riding an impressive 20-game hitting streak. Steve, Eric, what have you seen from him lately that's been making him successful, and how long you think he can ride this?
Well, it's really impossible to know how long he can keep this thing rolling. But I will say that he really looks like he's in a zone right now. I mean, when you think about it, even the balls that he doesn't hit particularly hard are still finding holes for him and doing some damage.
Yeah, Steve, he does seem to have some good luck on his side, but I will say, he looks awfully comfortable up there at the plate right now. Seems to be seeing the ball well, and his mechanics are very sound. Sometimes everything just comes together. That time is now for him. Like you said, Steve, we can't predict how long this will continue, but it certainly doesn't look like it's likely to come to an end in this one.
All right, pregame festivities are wrapping up. It's time for baseball, and we'll have it for you next.
So Meyer enters today's action looking to extend that hitting streak we just talked about to 21 games if he's able to get a hit against the San Antonio Missions today. He's going to settle into the box in the first inning looking to do just that. So with runners on first and second and a pitch high up in the zone, he slaps that to center field, and no drama here today. He's going to get it done in the first at bat, and he also collects an RBI, plating home the runner coming all the way around from second and scoring. That's 15 points for Meyer as he gets the solid hit and an RBI. So like I said, taking care of that hitting streak, at least for today, early on. So we got a 2-0 Frisco lead in the bottom of the first when we get a pop-up here. Meyer gonna try to make that catch, and whoa! That guy went just right through his body. Did you see that? What happened to collision detection? I don't know. Could he try to avoid him? I'm sure he felt a breeze as he ran right through his body, but anyway, he makes the catch, so no harm, no foul. Frisco up 2-0 in the third, and this ball's hit quite a ways to right center. It's going to split the difference between the center fielder and right fielder, and by the time they corral this, he's in at second base standing up with the double. Another good at bat, solid contact, extra base hit, and once again, he goes opposite field for a double. So looking really good on that swing here. He's got 2 hits already on the day. And coming up in the fifth, looking for more. Frisco up 2-1. And this pitch is going to be hammered to left center. Another double possibly? No! He lays out and makes a great catch. The center fielder robs him. Holy smokes, Reyna makes a play here. We've got to look at it again as he lays out and makes the sliding catch in the grass there. Great play to rob Meyer of his third hit of the game. So he comes up here now 2-for-3 thanks to a web jam from the center fielder, but still looking for that third hit as he knows he's making good contact today. In the seventh, he's going to do it again. Good contact through the hole between third and short, and it will be a base hit. He's on for the third time today and swinging a very hot Louisville slugger right now. 14 points in that at bat. Behind the dish now in the ninth, 4-1. Hopefully nobody will run right through his body this time. Nope, looks like he can make this catch without any issues there. And he makes that catch for another 5 points, fielding a fly ball out. So there you go, a 4-1 Rough Riders victory over the Missions. And Matt Meyer, a big part of that, 3 hits and 5 at-bats, a double and an RBI. and he stands out offensively here in Frisco's attack. So we come back the next day looking to extend that streak to 22 games if possible, and also make up some ground on the San Antonio Missions in the standings as they sit atop first place. So Meyer gets ready to get in that box once again here. And with a runner on second, he is going to get that ball to the second baseman. It's knocked down, but he has no play. That should be an infield hit. I definitely don't think that's an error. Nope, that's a hit. And the hitting streak is alive at 22 games. Once again, he's finished that early on in the ball game and has a chance just to kind of relax the rest of the time. This ball hit down the first baseline and fair, and Meyer will easily come around to score there, earning himself 10 points on the base paths as well. It's going well for Frisco, up 4-0. This ball's hammered, and oh my, another web gem. He's robbed again, this time by the shortstop laying out. Look at this in slow motion. Totally giving up the body to make an excellent catch. Ooh, boy. Web gems all around here. Meyer swinging a hot bat, but would have even better stats had he not been robbed a couple times. Nah, they're not going to be able to take that one away. That's hit hard for another single out to right center field. Good job by the center fielder to get the ball back in and not allow him extra bases once again. So another good at bat with solid contact and another Rough Riders win 4-1 as they take a couple from the Missions here and maybe get back in those standings here. We're just kind of getting up over the 500 level. And we got a day off for Meyer here, which is going to put them into the series against Tulsa. And we're now two games above 500 playing Tulsa, who is sitting exactly at 500 at 22-22. So let's see what we can do against the Drillers here. The first at bat, trying to extend this hitting streak to 23. That's just a dribbler. They're going to try to double him up, and no, he does beat that out. But that is definitely not a base hit. That's a pretty poor at bat there. Tulsa still up 2-0 in the fifth. Runner trying to go to second. Yeah, don't do that. You don't want to test his arm. As you're gunned down at second base, caught stealing. 10 points for Meyer, showing off the strong arm behind the plate once again as he's able to gun down this runner and get the out. So that's exactly what you want to do. Catcher, quick release on that throw. Get it to the first base side of the bag and get success there. But it is now 5-0, it looks like, Tulsa. And Meyer is 0-2, so a little bit of cause for concern as far as the hitting streak goes. Will it be able to reach 23 games? He's got a couple of bats in him probably left. This ball is skied to left field, but I don't think it's anything special. It's going to be fielded with no problem. However, it does allow a run to finally come home on the sacrifice fly, so at least it's a productive out. And he will get an RBI on the play, but he was looking for much, much more, including a hit. So the Riders get on the board. They're down 6-3 in the sixth, so they must be mounting some kind of a rally, getting him back to the plate here. This is slicing down the right field line. It's going to be foul, and it is tracked down, so it's another out. Will he get another at bat and another chance to try to extend the streak? Well, he will, but this is it, folks. This is the ninth inning. He's got to come through here. 0-3, would have been 0-4, except one of those was a sac fly and didn't count against his stats. It's 12-3. Game is essentially over, but he needs this hit. He finds a pitch. Oh, no. Hit to third, and they will double him up. The hit streak will officially end here at 22 ball games. Ah, well, he was due for one of these days sooner or later. The whole team took it on the chin, but that is the end of an impressive streak. Now he can kind of relax, and we're going to be able to sim forward here. I was looking for a good spot to do a little simming, but I did not want to interfere with the hit streak. So once that's over, we do that. And hey, nice. Without the advancement goals this year, you're actually able to go ahead and sim a little bit and get some points without penalizing your player. However, you do see if you do neglect these certain categories, they will diminish on you a little bit. So be careful with that. Make sure these ones with the downward arrow there are tended to, or you don't want to lose too many of your attributes.
Matt Vaskirjian back with the Minor League Pregame Show, counting you down to Double-A Texas League Baseball with tonight's version of the Bowman Prospect Spotlight. Matt Meyer is in that spotlight. Coming off a last game in which he was really outstanding in the clutch moments, collecting a whole bucket full of RBI, so he'll be looking to emulate that type of performance here again in this one.
Yeah, and you said it, Matt. He was clutch.
And you know, some guys just have that uncanny ability to come through when it really matters. Baseball is usually when there are runners in scoring position, and he found himself up in that situation a number of times. It was pretty special to watch him out there, so I'm excited to see what he does to back it up.
All right, the guys and I will be back to get this one started on the show right after this.
Well, that's cool. That was all prompted by a 4-RBI game, the first of his career. That obviously happened in the last game that we simmed. Now, I find these splits very interesting. Look at this. A right-handed batter struggling against left-handed pitchers. Well, I don't know. It's fair to say he's struggling. 282 and 4 RBIs. But compared to what he does against right-handers, it just seems to be a very odd but true stat here, as he's going to hit this ball fairly hard but right at the shortstop. So no hit there in that at bat. So I mean, it could just be that he just doesn't see many lefties so far on the season, and maybe that is the cause for the skew there. That's the only thing I can think of. He gets a base hit and an RBI right here, so once again taking it out on a right-handed pitcher. They're up 5-0, and he's gonna clobber this to center field. This have a chance to get out of here? Nah, I think it's gonna be caught at the warning track. So he gave it a ride, but no go. And that is about where we're going to leave off here in this episode. So he had the hitting streak snapped, but things are going quite well for him. Looking for that AAA call-up, doing a little simming, hoping we can get to that sooner than later, but definitely enjoying his time with the Rough Riders. As we come back next time, trying to push ourselves into AAA ball. Can we do it? Come on back next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.